Ladies and gentlemen, one of our best pilots out here and great friend, Joe Bender, here he is. See how nice the field looks? Joe Bender, a local cattle farmer. I can't do that. I wish I could. Anybody to dedicate it to? Brittany?
My girlfriend, Brittany, here.
There she is. There she is. All right.
This wonderful day, and of course tomorrow is 4th of July, and don't forget, we're free because of our vets. We got a lot of vets out there. God bless our vets. We got a special vet today in the crowd. One of them is first time here at the concert, of the Air Force. Joe and I got something special today. My two sons were Marines. One of them flew this flag today. We're going to unveil this flag for you guys. Got a lot of tradition. See you when we get back.
Air smoke on, and we're up. Chuck Tippett maneuver, you hold it down, let it fly off. See what you thought me to do it? Let's pull up again.
Now you got
it. Lance King is out here with the wing walking posters. Ladies and gentlemen, step right up. Joe Bender will sign all your wig-locking posters, $2 a piece, $2 a piece while they last, and everybody here will autograph your wig-locking posters. Caitlin will come out and lend a hand with the selling of the posters. All right, now the first maneuver is the climbing out of the cockpit. A lot of air shows ignore this part, but it's the most exciting part there is. See, Chuck is throttled back into a slow flight, and when he approaches, he'll go into a shallow glide, and Joe Bender will climb out of the cockpit without a parachute or a safety rope. Barely above stall, there he is, climbing out, walking the wing. No parachute, no safety rope. And Chuck Tippett is crawling by with that thing. Fantastic. And barely above stall. I don't know how he does it, I swear. Joe is in the middle of the wing. See there, a human javelin. Demonstrating the human javelin. Climbing over the flying wires. And there he stands. So he said he's got a surprise for us. We'll see what it is. I think he's going to make his way to the end of the wing. There he goes. Wing walking came about at the end of World War I. So we're looking at 1918. Ormer Locklear, a pioneer in the Army Air Services at the time, walking the wings of Curtis Jennings. What Joe is going to do is dangle underneath that wing by his ankles, wrapping his feet around the strut. Watch when he lets go of his hands. No parachute, no safety rope. This is the way the wing walkers did it in the 20s and 30s. Gladys Ingalls, Jesse Woods. Ready? There he is, hanging by his feet, under the wing. No safety rope, no parachute. Amazing. Absolutely amazing. Hi, Brittany, you can open your eyes now. He's back on the wing. Now he's going to make his way very carefully along that wing. You have to step on the intersection of the leading edge and the ribs. Not on the fabric. These are fabric-covered airplanes. You put your synthetic fabric on these airplanes. Give it a coat of dope, which is a plasticized lacquer. That's what aviation dope is. Stretches up the fabric. And then you put down a coat of silver paint. The silver paint reflects the ultraviolet of the sun. Without that, your fabric would deteriorate immediately. And then you can put down the color. Aviation dope is the same as you use on model airplanes. That can say beauty rate dope, draws up the fabric, it's waterproof. But you stand on a wing panel, you fall right through, so you don't step on the fabric itself. Without support. Now again, Joe will demonstrate the climb to the top. There he goes. Out of the cockpit, up to the top of the wing. And there he is on the top wing. Joe Bender, ladies and gentlemen, there he is. Yes, again, Chuck Tippett is the only guy in the world who can fly that thing at basically below stall speed. For the wing walking loop, followed by the unfurling of the flag to celebrate 4th of July. And the birth of America 240 years ago. Chuck is checking for ceiling. Yeah, you would get high enough in the loop. Chuck is high enough. And what he's done is flattened the pitch all the way back, and that works like the gears in your car. Full throttle, flat pitch, climbing up the hill. Up the hill we go. Altitude to dive for the loop. Now we're going to dive for that loop. Joe Bender on the top wing. There he is. Chuck checks for the ceiling. Looks like we have enough to pull this thing off. We're going to dive, hit 130 miles an hour. Is available. Tremendous job, absolutely. Absolutely, folks. They didn't go on that. Now he's going to unfurl the flag. You can see him working with it, which is not the easiest maneuver. You have to remember where you are and what you're doing. Got a little belt around the waist, but the you get the flag unfurled for the flag pass. So we're going to have a very good picture if you have a camera. All right, there's the flag. Now Joe's going to be on the top wing. The flag will be flying. This is quite spectacular.
Yeah.
Great job, Sam. Terrific on Lee Greenwood's version there. All right, flag still flying. We're going to sign the autographs of those of you with posters. Get ready to have Joe sign them. Meanwhile, the United States Army Air Corps forming up a formation to land at a flying circus fleur de lis. From France, and you know that it's Lise, not me. I don't know how he stays there. Was that awesome or what? Give him a hand, folks. Joe, you're the man. You're the man.
Thanks for those kind words. God bless our vets, and everybody have a wonderful 4th of July tomorrow.
There's nobody in the world who can fly the Stearman.